A very good afternoon, everyone. Respected panel members, faculties, and dear student managers. I, Soumya Sahu.
And I, Shriyanka Sharma.
We both are from River Godavari. Now, before we start our topic, I would like to ask a simple question.
What, please?
When it comes to politics, what comes to your mind, or maybe who comes to your mind? Yeah, correct. But there's a lot more which we'll be going through today.
So, as you all said, Narendra Modi. So, according to you, tell me, अच्छे दिन आए या नहीं? Okay. So, coming to our topic.
So, as you would have already get to know our topic, which is politicians are great marketers. Now, the very objective of taking this topic is politics has always been portrayed as the negative side with lot of controversies, but there's a lot of things which we'll be getting to know about it and learn from. Now, starting from the introduction, these are the contents which we'll be going through. As said by Crompton and Lamb, politics is marketing is about two things. First, it's a philosophy, attitude, and a perspective.
And second, it is a set of all activities which implement that philosophy.
Yes. Political and business marketing, they are all parallel to each other, and they both have been using the same media outlets, that is newspaper and different social media platforms. Both use the same market research and statistical analysis as well.
Now, coming to the planning of political marketing. Step one, political research. In political research, a researcher researches and provides a useful information to their political party members. Their primary duty is to resolve issues between their political party members. Now the second, make the decision to run or not to run. Whether the decision is beneficial for their political party or not, after that they decide to run that particular program or any particular issue. Now come to the third, collection or arranging of funds. In that, the party collect funds for their election and for other function of any election parties. Now come to the step four, division of the work. In that, they divide their work into different stages. Now coming to the fifth, implementation. In the implementation, they implement all the work. Now coming to the marketing strategies. Number one, posters and pamphlets. As we all know, the political parties promote their political party by using posters and pamphlets. Public appearance. In public appearance, a candidate appearance affects the voters making decision. If a politician's delivering a speech with a great body posture and a winning smile, that will affect and project their powerful image. Now coming to third, 3D hologram in election campaigns. It was a very innovative idea which was used during the last election by PM Narendra Modi, in which he was omnipresent.
Now stopped VIP culture. Basically, the red light which was used over the top of the vehicles of the VIPs and VVIPs, it was completely banned, which was of great help for the public. Then women empowerment. A number of women were given equal opportunities, like our Nirmala Sitharaman, first lady, as the first lady finance minister of India. Then textiles minister of India, that is Smriti Irani, and our former external affairs minister, that is Sushma Swaraj. Then coming to different yojanas, like Pradhan Mantra Jan Dhan Yojana was also implemented, in under which 15 million bank accounts were opened within a single week, and also Swachh Bharat Abhijan was also implemented. Now, these are the vital channels of marketing, which includes Chai Pe Charcha. This is basically an initiative started by Narendra Modi, in which he truly believes that tea stall is like, you know, roadside parliament, in which all the agendas could be discussed, and he could discuss with a mass number of people. Then newspapers, and then through radio, Man Ki Baat. Man Ki Baat is also an Indian program started by Narendra Modi, in which he discusses all the important agendas, the outcomes and the results which will benefit the mass media, and through television as well.
Now, coming to the social media, as social media is the platform in which politicians are providing their informations through Facebook, Twitter and YouTube channels without spending time. Now comes to branding. A branding is which like providing a branding is that promotion or promoting any particular brand continuously. In that, I would like to focus 2014 Lok Sabha election, which is a historical win of BJP. In that, they set the theme around Narendra Modi as a brand, in which the value of Narendra Modi is more than the value of the BJP party. Now coming to the slogans. The slogans are used by the politician in the election period, in which they used slogans which will affect to gain votes from the public and to attract in the public eyes, in the eyes of the public.
Now these are the competitors' failed campaign, in which the leader focus is missing. Then there's no previous credits with the person which is to be elected. Often statements made about the ruling party, which puts a very negative impact on the public. Then influence of the person, if it's not that powerful.
Now, delivery of political marketing. Target audience is expecting more. Promised benefits should be fulfilled. That the party has giving any promise to the public, they have to be fulfilled. Within a short span of time after winning, the party should start gaining confidence. Target audience can lose the charm if the delivery is improper. Now, the challenges faced by the politicians. Lack of internal democracy. The parties are lack of internal democracy, which keeps the prospective leaders derived for their own benefits. Dynasty succession. In that, the political leader use their powers for their close ones and for their family members by giving some benefits to them.
Now coming to money and muscle power, even within the political parties, they face a lot of problem regarding money and muscle power, because the person who is in power, we never know how the money is getting spent through, and they don't get the idea about it. Then no transparency, many yojanas and many policies which are being implemented, there's no transparency regarding the money which is being spent and regarding everything. Now coming to conclusion, political marketing is the process by which political candidates promote themselves and their platforms to voters, and they aim at gaining public support.
Politicians, government departments use marketing in their pursuit of political goals.
Thank you.